Good afternoon, Detroit. Good afternoon, you and Ron March. Ron March Show. We have taken this Tuesday to invite outside guests. We have a sister out of Texas. I'm going to find out what city she's from down in Texas. Her name is Ashira, and she has a blog talk down in Texas, and we're going to hook up today and see if we can't get some of this information out to them good Texans down there. All right? Now, while we're waiting on her, I want to talk about my website. I get a lot, too many phone calls asking me questions that are definitely on my website. And I want you, if you have anything you want to ask me, right first, go to blog. I want you to go to my website, ronmarch.com. ronmarch.com. And at that point, you go across the top where you see blog. And from blog, I want you to tap it. And when you tap blog, you're going to get the four articles, beautiful, four beautiful articles. And I want you to read those articles first. It covers the basics of all of the questions that I get daily. Yes, we're getting, I'm getting too many phone calls asking the same questions. Now, my web. Yep, Ashira, Texas. She's calling in on my cell. Let me find the cell first.
We're going to go ahead and play some music.
Yep, go ahead, tap it. I'm getting away. I'm getting 6 minutes. She ain't started. I'll be calling in 6 minutes. Yep.
All right.
Yes. Okay, what I'm saying is I'm getting too many phone calls asking the same questions. And then you want to add information as to, I got this from Fred, I got it from Josephine, and they told me to do this, they told me to do that. I do not need to hear that. I do not need to hear that. I'm on point, and if you call me, I want you to be on point. And I'm going to say it again. I'll try to remember to say it several times during the show, at least a couple more times. I want you, before you call me, go to my website, ronmarch.com. Go across the top. Go to blog. When you open up blog, there are four articles in there. Three of them are right on target. It tells you about your, it explains to you about the birth certificate, the entire process of the birth certificate. There's another powerful article. It's called The Straw Man and the Treasury Department. You need to know these things. Don't call me. You got to do your own research. I'm not going to do the research for you, and I'm not going to teach you in a phone call. Now, my producer is telling me that I need to set up some consultation hours or information, which I'm looking into, but I can't do everything at one time. So when you call and you want that long, drawn-out conversation about Fred told me to do it this way, my paperwork came back, and I want to get into this, I want to get into that, there will be a half an hour. I'm going to charge a half an hour fee. I haven't put a tag on it. I haven't put a dollar on it. But it will be posted on my website. And when you call me, I'm going to ask you, have you been to my website? And don't try to skip around it. I had one guy try to skip around it, and I just said, well, you haven't read my site. You're asking me questions, and the answer's right there on the site. Now, let's all understand one thing. None of us have a good education. I get emails that spelling words that are concocted that I have to guess what they are. But I understand that. We are not educated individuals in our own language. We don't have any type of PhDs or anything in our in this crazy ass English language. We don't like to speak it anyway, so no big deal to me. So let's not act like we all know something. That's why I want you to go and read. You have to read. You cannot be free if you don't know how to be free. If I had a silver coin and I told you this coin will give you freedom from here to the end of eternity, put it in your pocket. Ain't a damn thing you can do with it if you don't know the information that's needed in order to use that silver piece I gave you. And I'm not going to explain it to everybody that calls me where the silver dollar or where the silver piece is. You need to study it for yourselves, because no one in America has the same problem. One thing we do have, and it is a problem, we're all mad. We're all discontent with this bullcrap called the United States of America. I understand it. You understand it. It's nothing new. We also understand that the corporations and the plea of enforcement are crooks. I understand it. You understand it. And she didn't hit the one yet. I understand it. You understand it. And so let's not even go into that. They're just as crooked in your neighborhood as they are in mine. Now, I'm going to, I see our sister's about ready to start up. I'm going to tell her to tap when she gets ready. I want her to tap the number one. There you go. All right. All right. All right. Are you there, Sister Ashira?
I am. I'm here, Brother Ron, and I'm getting ready to click you in and merge you into our line.
All right.
I kept calling in, but you know what? I kept getting disconnected. I called, like, this is like my fourth time calling in.
Wow.
Well,
okay.
You know how they do. You know how they, you know,
yes,
you're dropping
yes,
these bombs.
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
so I'll merge us in, okay?
All right. I'll hear
right.
you when you, yep. Let me know
okay.
when you're ready.
Ready.
All righty. All right, good evening, everyone, from the Texas audience, Detroit audience, all over the United States. Everybody is listening in. I picked up last night, I picked up a big audience. I was working with, she dropped out?
Yep, she dropped out.
Yep. Oh, okay.
We'll be watching for it.
We'll watch for you to come back if you can hear me, Ashira. I noticed that your call was dropped, so we'll get you. Yep. I picked up a big audience last night. I did a very good program with Jonah Bay and a couple of more brothers out of Georgia. And we did a two-hour piece. It was supposed to be an hour, but it stretched out into 2 hours. Everybody was pleased with the information. And so this is the type of thing we got to do. We got to get the word out to everyone so those that want to be free can be free. But you got to want it. And what comes with the want, W-A-N-T, is study, research, reading. You have to read. You're not going to drive me crazy with your drama, because everybody's got problems. You got to do research on your own. I can set you on the path, but I can't do the research. And common sense is another a clear area that we need to deal with. Common sense. When you're dealing with these people, you have to use common sense. It's not difficult. It's not difficult. Start looking at some of the programs on TV, such as Law and Order, such as NCIS, that type of thing. You can learn from those programs. You need to know the process. And it's a very simple process. In order for it to be truth, it must be stated as truth. And if you're dealing with courts, it must be written as truth. Don't come out telling me, oh, he knew better. The judge knew that the guy was lying, and the judge knew that the guy took. That's not going to work. If you don't bring it to the judge's attention or put it in your paperwork that he was a lying shenanigan, then there's no need of you even talking to me. There you go. I see your back, sister. Oh, yep, I hear you.
I'm here.
Right.
I'm here. You know, was disconnected, but we are here, Brother Ron March. How are you?
All right. I'm very good today. And you? Now, first of all, real quick,
well.
What city are you? All right. What city are you in down there in Texas? You in Dallas?
Again?
Where are you? What city?
In Houston. Houston,
oh, you're
Texas.
In Houston. All right. All right. Mm-hmm. I'm getting calls from Texas. A couple of brothers called me about an hour before the show, and I told them I'd be on with you tonight, so be sure and listen. And I wasn't sure of your city, but they were out of Dallas. So I told them that they can get you and tune in and call in if they have any questions. Okay.
Fantastic.
Now, tonight's show, we must deal with one of the major problems that we are having as black, so-called black, or indigenous people. We need to understand the 14th Amendment. We need to understand the 14th Amendment. Now, let me explain why it's so important. The dates of all of the tampering with the Constitution started in 1863. The three main amendments that we need to know about is 13, 14, and 15. I'll tell you real quick. 15 deals with the right to vote. 13 deals with the lie that there's no slavery or involuntary servitude. That's 13. Now, 14 was the most important amendment because when they started the invisible government, I'll call it that right now, when they started the invisible government of 1871, they did not have any subjects in their corporation. You have to have three, I call them ingredients, but three items are in every corporation: the grantor, the trustee, and the beneficiaries. The grantor is always one person, to my knowledge. And then your trustees can be as many as you select in your bylaws. And then the beneficiaries can be 10 million. It doesn't matter about the beneficiaries. Now, you got to understand that. I'll say it again. There are three parts, sections to all trust, except one, and I'll bring that up later. There are three parts to all trust. Number one, the grantor. That's the one that formed the trust. Number two, the trustee. He was appointed by the grantor and given the power to appoint other trustees for different assignments. And then there's
Brother Ron?
Yes.
Brother Ron, pardon
yes.
me. I just want to know if you could check with your audience to see if they're able to hear you, because I myself have a terrible connection. I'm not hardly hearing anything that you're saying.
Okay.
And let me see.
My engineers are here.
Canty, you're on the line. Can you hear him, Canty?
He can't hear me.
Yeah, I can hear him.
You can hear him? Okay, so it's just my phone.
Yeah.
Okay.
How do you do?
Yep. See you again? Are you there?
I'm here.
Here?
I'm here.
Okay.
Yes.
How you doing, brother?
Okay. On our internet, my website is coming in clear. So that might be your connection, Ashira.
Yes.
So we'll do it in the
terrible.
Open the chat room. It's still bad?
I tell you what, let me hang up and call back in and see if that
will
take care of this problem.
Mine's chopping up also.
Can't he just hang on and the rest of the callers, I will call right back in.
It's got to be your fault.
Yep. Yep. I wonder why that didn't go away. Okay. Open this up so I can see.
Okay, what up?
Hit this, hit that, and then hit that.
No, that's this.
That ain't what I've been getting. Oh, I see you got it that way.
Yeah.
Let me see this way 1 minute and see what happened this way.
No. Don't hit that. Uncheck that.
From Al Henderson.
Yeah. see what he's doing. He's saying, Al, I hear you clearly. Yep. Okay, it's not us. How you? I got you, Al. Everybody hears us clear. It's got to be her phone or her connection, personally. See, that's what it'd be lining up here. Yep. I never used that other one that you showed me. Yep. Okay. We have to understand the sections or the items that are in a trust. I'll say it again. Number one is the grantor. He is the one that came up with the idea and put it in his name. He's the grantor. Now, he, when he puts his paperwork together, he will appoint a trustee, trustees, three, it doesn't matter. Whatever he has in mind, he can appoint it them. He can also give one trustee the power to appoint other trustees for specific jobs, for a specific time. All of that is in the bylaws. All of that's in the makeup of the paperwork. That's what they say when you go to the bank. I need to see your paperwork, your instruments. Then there's the beneficiaries. Okay? Now, when these Europeans came to the United States, they had treachery, thievery, invading. They had all of the items of takeover in their hearts when they came here. They were sent here to take over. They finagled their way in, stating they wanted to set up 13 colonies. And they named those colonies, listen carefully, United States. The 13 colonies were known as United States. You've got to understand that. And when they print their information on constitutional law and government, they will write it the same way I'm talking it. They'll talk about United States. When you hear United States, they're talking about 13 colonies that were on the East Coast in a 10 square mile of a radius only. It was given to them in the original Constitution, Article 1, Section 8, Paragraph 17. You can go there and read it. They were designated a district to set that trash up. Their intent was never to stay there. Their intent was to take over the entire continent, North America continent. And notice, when they talk about America, they never talk about United States. They say North America, South America, Central America, America. We live in America. We do not live in United States. Hear me, keep clear. If you can't understand that, that's why they shoot your butts. That's why they got you in debt, because you don't understand not only who you are, where your land and or your territory is. You live in America. I'll get fancy and say it was known as El Maroc. When they came over, it was El Maroc in the beginning. El Maroc. But since the European couldn't speak Arabic or Latin, they just make up crap. So it sounded like America to them. That was one of the major problems that they had. They could not speak the language that was here. That's why they came up with quote-unquote English and made you study English, and they called it the Christian language. This is so simple to me. It's just redundant for me to keep saying this over and over, but I know you're not getting it because your conversations do not reflect that you understand. So we're going to work on it tonight. Now, I'm going to tell you, when they created this madness, they were on the East Coast. They had 13 colonies. They had an area called District of Columbia. They had a capital of District of Columbia. It was known as Washington. That's why they call it Washington, D.C., District of Columbia. That section in the original organic constitution that I just quoted, Article 1, Section 8, Paragraph 17, it says you are given a district to create your government. Your seat of government will be on a 10 square mile radius. Now, that was in 1789 when they signed all of that. Now, their intent was to steal, rob, loot, rape, take over all of the products in this land. I just got some information the other day, and I'm going to research this, but I'm going to just tell it to you because the time is right to run it. The United States of America was incorporated in London in 1783. They signed the new contract or the new constitution in the United States in 1789. But it was already incorporated in London, Great Britain, London. The United States of America is a territory of Great Britain. Y'all got to get this. I know it's hard because they beat you half to death and made you go to them sorry-ass public schools, and you don't know a damn thing. I'm saying it to you like it is. They taught you what they wanted you to know. And you're nothing but an ignorant robot or a plantation dweller. There you go. That's a good one. All right. The colonists did not win the Revolutionary War. The British troops won. They did not leave until 1797, almost the turn of the century. They stayed and set it up. Now, what you read in the books of Revolutionary War is what I call historical revisionism. They had to make the story good to teach it to you. Great Britain owns United States. That's why all your judges, prosecutors, lawyers, police officers, all of these crooks have a bar. They belong to the bar. B-A-R, that's the acronym. It stands for British Accredited Registry. Y'all got to get this. Because they have a right to shoot and kill you. The police are only following laws and rules that were set up. You are a slave. You have no rights. You only have privileges and benefits. When they want to get tired of your black ass, they'll take those privileges and benefits away. If you know anybody in the Masonic Order, ask them, do they know what poor man, I'm going to say it right, poor man rate, P-O-O-R-R-A-T-E, R-A-T-E. No, I said it wrong. Poor man rate. Poor man rate is when they kill a slave or a subject, they have to pay the poor man rate. That's why they switched it to the civil rights issue. When cops kill black folks, they don't go to prison. They have to sue through federal court, and they get a monetary gain out of it. It's known as the poor man rate. P-O-O-R-M-A-N. R-A-T-E, poor man rate, okay? Now, when they come out of that 1800 coming forward, their intent was to quickly destroy all the government, all the trust. Now, try to work with me on this. A trust to me, is that right?
No.
Trust to me is what they call Big Mama. There you go. I lost my concentration for a second. Big Mama. Big Mama was the trust. She ran everything, just like your Big Mama ran everything. If you needed to solve a problem, you take it to Big Mama. That's how our government was set up. It's known as the matriarch system. The male was the protector. The mama was the law. That's why Big Mama was so powerful. The European could not work with that. He could not get to Big Mama, so he had to change it. We won't go into that tonight. But they did a very good job of tricking Big Mama to do certain things, and now it's all gone. Okay? But as we move forward, going into the 1800s, the Europeans, you see how I can go back? Wow. I wonder if they probably can't even hear. Yep. Okay. I'm going to continue. Yep. I'm gonna try and give her, y'all bear with me a second, because we want to see what her problem is and see if is there anything we can do to help her out. Here's her Yeah, that's her number. But I was going to give her a text here and there. Yeah, that's her number. Yep. Okay. Now, listen carefully. I don't want to jump too fast and get too far ahead of myself because I'm still waiting on her to call in. Okay? Here she is. She's back. Are you there, Ashir? Hello? Let me open up her mic.
Can you hear me? Listen.
Yes, I can.
I've been trying to call in for now 30 minutes, and it's just ridiculous. They will not let me merge our calls. Is there some kind of way where you can call me? Because every time I call, the phone just disconnects. Every time I call you on my other line.
All right.
They're trying to prevent us, but if you can call me, and then maybe I can merge from there. Okay.
Right,
it's 713-767-0067.
Yep. All right, now hold on.
All right. Okay.
I want my people to hear, so we're going to have, she wants me to call her.
Let's do it. I'm going to hang up.
We're going to hang up. Give us 5 minutes and we'll be back. Okay?
I got it.
All right. I'm just going to put some music on.
Well, we're not going to be able to hear. So
all right.
I'm about to call right now.
And I know you get her. I'm gonna open it up over there. I hear it rings. Then I hit that button to place it over there. Are you there, Ashir?
Okay. Let's see, Brother Ron.
Yes, I'm here.
All right, we had to work through all of that, but I am here and you're there, and let's go for it.
All right.
Let's do it. We're not going to let them stop us.
No, we got it. Now, I don't know how much you heard, but I'll continue, and then you can ask questions. Have your people ask questions, call in and whatever, because I started back when they came to America. They came to America and to set up the corporations in 1604. The Virginia Company was the first colony that was set up. And from 1604, it blossomed into 13 colonies. The 13 colonies are known as United States. Hear me clear. United States. Okay. You've got to know that because when you read history, they'll tell you, they'll say United States. Seldom do they say United States of America. It's got to be after 1871 before they use United States of America. Okay. We were in charge of America when they came here. America was known then, as I was told, El Moloch. Because we were here doing our thing. They came in. They made a contract. They were supposed to set up a commercial commerce program. We, as inhabitants of America, were supposed to receive benefits from them being here. That's why we gave them the Constitution. In the Constitution, I said it, it says in Article 1, Section 8, Paragraph 17, it says that they gave them 10 square miles to seat the government of United States. It's in writing right there in the original Constitution. They had treachery, a murder, looting, stealing, invasion, all of the negatives was in their minds during this whole period, but they did it under a secret order. The Illuminati could be one, because we know about Adam Wassenoff. Adam Wassenoff, he was the one that started the Illuminati. You can look him up. I pronounce it Adam Wassenoff. So, they were setting up all these treacherous moves in order to engulf the entire North American continent. Now, it should be surprising to you, that they only call it North America, South America, and Central America. Where is United States? It don't exist. Corporation. If they put United States in North America, South America, and Central America, they might as well put General Motors, Chrysler, and Ford. All of them are corporations, not governments, not continents. And I'm screaming on this because you got to understand it. If you're going to be free, you got to know the difference between private law and public law. Private citizen and public citizen. It's two different entities. They don't mix. They do not mix. Once you clear your birth certificate, you are a private citizen. Without the birth certificate, you are a slave. I don't give a damn if you got a PhD, a master, a bachelor, it don't matter. You can be a CEO. You can be anything you think you, even the president. If you don't have your birth certificate in order, you are a slave or a subject to United States, which is the 13 colonies. Now, how do they spread themselves out? They use a little program called the Buck Act. B-U-C-K, Buck Act, and they did it. Buck, B-U-C-K, Buck Act. They used the Buck Act, and they spread themselves and got out of the territory of the 10 square miles, all on the illegal process, and we'll talk about that if we have time, but I want to stay on this 14th Amendment because everyone listening that has not separated themselves from the all caps are 14th Amendment citizens. You don't have any rights. You have privileges and benefits. And if you're not a good boy or a good girl, they will take those away from you. Now, I hope I'm making this clear when I run this.
Yes.
And I'm trying to make it as clear as I can. Because if you can't get this, I'm telling you, you're going to be in a hocus-pocus trick bag for the rest of your life. And there ain't no sense in me trying to soft pedal it. It ain't going to work. Now, here's where the trick came. In the Declaration of Independence, now listen to these words carefully. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. That too secures these rights. Governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed. So we as men own the government. That whenever any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it and to institute new government, laying its foundation on such principles and organizing its powers in such form as to them shall seem most likely to effect their safety and happiness. Now, what I'm saying to you is, when they came in here shucking and jiving, trying to make themselves look like they are going to do right, their intent was nothing but treachery from the beginning. Okay, I got some area here I got to take up. All right, Putin's indeed will dictate that governments long established should not be changed for light and transit causes. And accordingly, all experience has showed that mankind are more disposed to suffer while evils are sufferable than to right themselves by abolishing the forms to which they are accustomed. But when a long train of abuses and upsurgence pursuing involuntary the same object, oh, these words are terrible, invinces a design to reduce them under absolute depositionism, it is their right, it is their duty to, hold on, I'm moving it up, to throw off such government and to provide new guards for their future security. Such has been the patient sufferance of these colonies. You're talking about the colonies. And such is now the necessity which constrains them to alter their former system of government, which would be Great Britain. The history of the present king of Great Britain, King George III, is a history of repeated injuries and usurpations. There you go. All having in direct object the establishment of absolute tyranny over these states, 13 colonies. To prove this, let facts be submitted to the world, to a candid world. Now, they're talking about being free under your creator. Under your creator, to be free. Now, if we move over to 14th Amendment, let me see, make sure I got it. I done knocked off the 14th Amendment. Hold on 1 second. My stuff is jumping around. United States Congress, 14th Amendment. That ain't no, hold it. I had a good one up, and I must have knocked it off. But anyway, the 14th Amendment says all of your rights, and it'll come up in a minute, all of your rights, liberties, and pursuit of happiness comes from the government. You see the difference? You gave up God to agree to the government. Now, rest assured they were not talking to you and I at that time, because we had nothing to do with the Constitution. It was written, and it was the Moors on the East Coast, we have no idea who they were. They set up this thing called the Declaration of Independence and the Constitution. Okay. Now, when we're talking about United States, we got to remember that. So, when they got up to the 14th Amendment, which was passed in 1868, they came up with new rules and regulations. So let's see if we can't bring that up, because it's only five 14th Amendment. It was only five sections of it. 14th Amendment. And they have a preamble to it. And the preamble, y'all hold on a minute, hold on. I had a very good one. I must have. Now, here we go. The 14th Amendment. 14th Amendment addresses many aspects of the citizenship. Now, Section 1 talks about all persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof. Notice they said United States. You got to listen carefully. United States. They're not talking to you and I. I'll start again. All persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof, that's tricky, but we'll come back to that, are citizens of the United States and of the state wherein they reside. No state shall make or enforce any law which shall abridge the privileges and immunities of citizens of the United States, nor shall any state deprive any person of life, liberty, and prosperity without due process of law, nor deny to any person within its jurisdiction the equal protection of laws. Now, what are we talking about? We're talking about the 13 colonies. They did not mention America. They were not talking to us. That was a trick. And when they got to the Book Act, for example, I'll give you some of the Book Act. You got a post office, you got a mailbox. It belongs to the federal government. That's why they put restrictions on your mailbox, tell you where to put it. That is a contract. So the mailbox is hanging on your house. So technically, the mailbox belongs to the federal government. So the federal government said that area where that box is United States. What else do? They go into the cities. They give them grant money for schools. That money comes from United States. But once they give the money in, they begin to dictate to the schools what to teach and what not to teach. Once you start setting your budget on outside money that do not belong to you, that you put yourself in a hell of a position, because once they see that you're using their money and you're looking good, they turn around and say, well, we're going to pull our money out if you don't do this and do that. You're not going to teach black history. You're going to teach Negro history. You see the catch? And they can do that, but they're only doing it through, what would be a word I could use? Acquiescence? They're doing it through a contract. I'll just say that. They're doing it through a contract. Look at what they did to these jackleg-ass preachers. The First Amendment in the Constitution says, you have a right to religious beliefs, and you will not be taxed. Every state has a constitution. It says the same thing. You cannot be taxed for religious reasons. So, after the Martin Luther King and all that, them nigga preachers got out there with all that garbage, and they were setting Martin Luther King up to sign the Civil Rights Act, they decided to set up what was known as 501c3. Now,
okay.
Here these niggas out there, they already got freedom of taxes. They don't have to pay no taxes. It's all in the Constitution. But no, they're going to turn around and sign up for 501c3. Now, what does that mean? 501c3 had its own jurisdiction. They put money in the process of 501c3. That so-called, I'm going to call it Christian Initiative. It's some kind of initiative that's got gobs of money in it. That's where them jackleg-ass preachers are building them huge, humongous churches, because they're getting a loan backed up by the the initiation, whatever they call that thing. So now they're in with the government. So now the government, through the 501c3 jurisdiction, can tell them what to say and what not to say.
Yes. Brother Ron.
Yes, ma'am.
So the churches, they're able to, I think it was, I believe it was T.D. Jakes, and I know it was a church in Memphis where they had the humongous offensive Statue of Liberty right in front of the church. I think it was World Overcomers, Life Changers, something like that. I don't know. But anyway, but they were all considered like, they took part of that faith-based initiative.
Yeah, there you go. That's the name of it. Yes, go ahead.
Right. And but I think I just read recently that churches are now under 501c4.
Well,
I think that's it. But anyway, all right. Of it is all, I'm really interested in what you're saying about these 501c3s, because I hear conflicting thoughts. So please do share.
Well,
continue. I just had to jump in for a second.
All right, that's good. But always remember, when you sign your name, you always create a contract. So in order, I don't care if it's 501c3, 4, 5, 6, 99, 22, 48. I could care less.
I know that's right.
Each one of those initiatives have a jurisdiction, and there are rules in order for you to get the benefit, going back to benefits, you must abide by the rules.
Mm.
You got it? And that's why
they
always threatening them dumbass preachers. Well, if you ain't gonna act right, that's what they told him with Martin Luther King. Well, we're gonna make you start paying taxes. How can they do that when the Constitution says you don't have to pay taxes if you have a religious institution? You cannot tax a religious concept. All you gotta do is read it. It's in the United States. I'll look it up, and when we come back from break, whenever we take a break, I'll look it up from Michigan, and I'll read it to you. It says one of the rights is you can have freedom of religion. Freedom of religion. Freedom means no impediments. The same way they say you have freedom to travel. You have a right, not a privilege. They call it right to travel. And then they trick us and say, you got to get licensed. Out of our ignorance, we get licensed, we get insurance, we get registration. And then now they got us so tangled up, we don't bit more know what the hell's going on. And then they put our brothers and sisters at these junkyards and these tow truck places and at the police station. They don't know a damn thing. So here comes a tow truck to take your car. And I know I'm getting off the subject. But you have never asked a tow truck for his pickup number that he must have in order to pick up your car.
He
is hijacking your car.
That's right.
And nobody thinks to sue the tow truck company first. That's who you sue.
Is that why they sneak and do it at night, Brother Ron?
That's why they do it.
Is that why they sneak and repossess the cars at night?
Yes.
Thinking
yes,
you're asleep.
Yes. And sometimes when
they
got
don't know when people behind on their car note, they're looking out the window.
That's right. And you got to have a flashlight in order to see the license plate number. He know where to go and get it. Now, what you will see at night, if he's a white driver, and most of the time they are white when they go at night because they're scared to go in the daytime to get their ass pulled, you're going to see a police car that a police car would drive by first. Now, how did that police patrolman know? That truck driver went to the precinct and said, I'm going to pick up Ron March's car. Here's the paperwork from the finance company. Here's Ron March's address. I'll be over there between 3 and 4 o'clock on the a.m. Now, the police are supposed to protect him, but he's still stealing your car because you don't have a contract with the tow truck company. Everything in America is on a contract basis because of 1871, when they created United States of America, Inc., is a corporation. You got it?
Got it.
Okay. Now.
Following you.
Yes, it's deep. Now, I say, always said, that these young boys that have no idea who they are, where they come from, most of them don't give a damn, wearing them pants around their knees, wearing that hat on backwards. They don't realize that they are sitting ducks for the enforcement agencies. They are sitting ducks. And if you read the laws of the enforcement agencies, which would be, they normally are hidden, and they come under, I think I told you back when Michael Brown got killed, that they had a law on the books that they had a right to shoot you in the back if you will announce that you are a police officer, and if they turn and run away, you have a right to shoot, no, use deadly force to pursue them. I read that law to you. But what I didn't know was somebody had sued the state of Missouri, and the Supreme Court ruled that you got to take that law out, but they didn't tell the people. So they were in their right. That's why that boy couldn't go to jail for shooting Brown, because it's on the books. He turned. Once he made contact, whatever happened at that window, they made contact. I don't care. If he spit on him, slapped him, or called him a nigger, it doesn't matter. There were contact made. And then when Brown turned and ran, the guy had a right to shoot him. I read that law on the air. And then I was told, they sent me a cup of something, that it was repealed back, earlier, but they didn't tell the people. And the lawyers never brought it up in the court case. And now we're going to go back to the 14th Amendment, because Michael Brown was a 14th Amendment slave. He was murdered by the police department. All they had to do was try the cop, find him not guilty. So they said, we're not even going to put him in court, not enough evidence. So he was found not guilty. Here comes Holder. Now, Holder's job is to make us as niggas believe that he's going to help us. He knew before he left Washington there was nothing he could do. Why? Because if he charged him for the murder, it would be double jeopardy. So what else could he charge him for? So what did they do? They came up with the Civil Rights Act. And the Civil Rights Act called it a unlawful killing, or they got a name for it. So now the only thing can happen is the family will get money. Same way that other boy with the hood on his head. They got money. That's all. Same way up in New York with the cigarette. The family's going to get money. Same thing in Detroit when they shot that girl in the face with a double barrel shotgun, 7-year-old baby sleeping on the couch. And they said it was justified because granny hit the shotgun. She screamed, "You're a damn lie," right in court. And they said they didn't have enough evidence to hold the police officer. But they're going to get money. And it comes under civil rights. And civil rights comes under the 14th Amendment. That was the worst thing Martin Luther King could ever do. He signed the Civil Rights Act. And he said in so many words that all niggas in the United States of America are now 14th Amendment citizens. The same way that Section 1 said, all, listen to this, who gave them punks, calm down, Ron, who gave them individuals who gave them individuals in Washington, D.C. on a 10-square-mile hand-me-down with 13 colonies known as United States? Now keep that in mind. Who gave them the right to say all persons born or naturalized in the United States and subject to the jurisdiction thereof? Subject to the jurisdiction thereof is anybody that's got a mailbox on their door, on their house. You come under the United States mail jurisdiction. Y'all hear me? This is some deep stuff.
Yes, indeed.
And they're known as, listen, they're known as citizens of United States. I ain't never want to be no citizen of the United States, of the 13 colonies, and of the state wherein they reside. So wherever you at with that mailbox, consider yourself a citizen of the United States. And see, a lot of people think, you probably think so too, Ashura, that so-called mailman is a federal worker. He is not.
Yeah.
The only time you will see post office is on the building. They have to do that because they have to do that, or they will lose their all that madness about the Buck Act cannot work if they lose their postal charter. So what they did, they leave the name up to benefit the postal charter. And then they changed the inside, the workers, and called them United Service, Postal Service, USPPS, whatever that crap is. That's a private-owned corporation. United States Service Postal Service. There you go. United States Postal Service. USPS. That's what they call it. That do not belong to the federal government. That belongs to some crony up in Washington who made a deal and he set it up. That's why they keep raising the rates, because they're for profit. Postal Service has never been for profit. Post Office has never been for profit. And I've been told if you go to Washington, D.C. tomorrow, the charter is in Washington, D.C. They have to keep that office open. You can go in there and buy a stamp for a penny, because they're not allowed to raise it unless it comes from somewhere in Switzerland. Every country has to go to Switzerland to get that postal charter. Oh, help me, somebody. I'm telling you, we need to know this. Because if you're going to get free, you got to know what freedom is. Freedom means you are private. You have nothing to do with them. They're in there. Now, you have to, since they screwed it up, you have to maintain your straw man. Why? Because they took all our gold and silver. Granny, if you remember, Granny had some silver or gold in an old nasty handkerchief tied up under her bed or somewhere. You laughing. You know I'm right. And they made Granny turn that in. In 1933, they put out the rule. Now, Granny did not have to do it, but they thought that they were being Christians. They thought they were doing the right thing. And then what did the preachers tell them? Well, if you didn't do the right thing, don't worry about it, because you'll get yours in the by and by. If I ever hear a preacher say that to me, I swear I'm going to bust him in his mouth. I say, see if you can get that in the by and by. You know what I'm trying to say. But that's what they teach us, to be passive. The Christian code was set up because they could not do anything. They were scared of black people. 1724 was the birth of the Christian code. 1724. The European was scared of the Native American. We were Native Americans, all of us. And they can do certain things to make you act right. Remember Roots, what they did to Toby.
Mm-hmm. It made him,
yes. That same thing happens. Try to visualize you are in the 13 colonies. You're fishing in a river. Where you fish at, and this is going on right now. My nephew called me the other day. He said, Unc, what we was talking about with the Indians, said it's going on right now. They're arguing over a treaty clause that said that the Europeans can only fish for perch or some good fish, I guess it's perch, only do it 2 months out of the year. If they're caught, they get fined. Yes. The Europeans are trying to overthrow the treaty. They can't do it because the treaty is older than the United States. It's older than the Peckerwood itself. They've been fighting up there in upper Minnesota, trying to get those Indians to make a deal to let them fish either year-round or 6 months out of the year. And the treaty say, don't bring your ass up here, but 2 months out of the year. If we catch you up here any other time, you're going to go to jail. Yes. And if my nephew calls in, I'm going to have him tell you about it, because he told it to me. Those Dakota Indians up there. They said that you can forget it. We ain't giving you Europeans, we ain't giving y'all nothing. So don't worry about it. Unbelievable.
And they shouldn't.
No.
And they shouldn't.
No.
No.
But see, what they'll do certain things, like kill the perch. They'll throw dynamite in there and kill the fish. They do things like that.
Mm-hmm.
When you
poison the water and all that.
Oh, yes. Yes, yes. I had a guy recently, like 10 years ago. He said that they were putting poison in the water, so his pigs, when they drank the water, they died. You know, but they couldn't prove it because they were doing it either at night or they were doing it up river, upstream, or whatever it was. and he couldn't catch it. So the sheriff, being on their side, is going to say, I need proof.
Of course.
Yeah.
Just like, what is it, the Koch brothers, Georgia Pacific Company, depletes all of its waste, and I think it's this, like, upstream river somewhere near, somewhere in Arkansas. And in this little small town, 80% of the people have died from respiratory cancer. It's only a few people left, and they have breathing problems. And in Louisiana, you know, in Louisiana, there's some kind of like indigenous people there that are fighting about, I think it's the oil spill that has put the water and the land over there and the food. And so they're having like one funeral a week because there's so many people dying. Okay, I apologize. I digress.
I heard a program on public radio. They were talking about Oklahoma. There's so many oil wells out in Oklahoma, and the drilling is causing earthquakes. They say they get 3,000 earthquakes a year.
That's right.
I said,
right.
3,000 a year, but then they said it's only a two. For first, it was a 1 to 2 tremor, you know, and now it's getting up to 2 or 3 number. And they said if at the rate, it's going to soon be 5, and then they'll tear down the houses, and the insurance company won't let them give them any type of earthquake insurance.
Wow.
And they're complaining.
Brother Ron, do you want to take a call?
Yes.
Do you want to take
please.
A call? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Brother Canty? Brother Canty, you have a question or a comment?
No, I'm just amazed at what the brother's saying. That I'm just taking it all in. My brother, can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Go ahead.
Hello?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, hello, I can hear you.
You have the Brulees. You've got the Secret Order, Masonic Order. You've got these blacks who betrayed the mess of the black people when we lost our Reconstruction rights. And they were willing to go along with the program as long as they were able to cut a niche for themselves. And they didn't give the Republicans in the North or the Democrats in the South any heat about the betrayal of the withdrawal of our Reconstruction rights.
Yes.
Now, the modern times, you have the 501c3, and now you've got the more elevated or revived edition. But the black church right now has long ago been compromised ever since the assassination of Dr. King. So would you say we are, like Malcolm said, we are double trap, triple trap because we are chumps?
Yes, if you're asking me, everything you said is true. But the only thing I would challenge, and I don't like the word challenge, the only thing I would say about what you just said, it didn't start with Martin Luther King. The reason that you didn't hear from the preachers, they were scared to come out. King abucked the system when he came out. That's why they had to engulf him.
Yes.
They had to engulf him. They call it, the Chinese call it in communism, they had to co-opt King. That's how they killed him, because they infiltrated him with snitches, Brulees, Masons, and all them damn crooks. Because you know in the hotel where he was killed, I don't know if you know this, but the security guard that was on duty, that dragging his feet and talking that old Uncle Remus shit, he was an undercover intelligence lieutenant in the Army. And they said nobody knew it. He was keeping track and turning in everybody that went in and out of the gate. And when they finally found out, because when they read his notes, they were all precise at 10:05 or at 1300, that Army talk, 6, whatever, went in, stayed 14 minutes, came back out. It was so precise. Everybody said, where'd this come from? They said it was all that old Uncle Remus nigga at the gate. That cat was undercover.
Wow.
Oh.
I was going to say also that during slavery, the slave master invented the black pastor, but they didn't call them pastors, then they call them parson. And it goes back to slavery where the sermons was edited by the slave master, making sure the slave master, the parson, was preaching the right sermons to his slaves so that the slaves would be obedient and accept the slave conditions.
Yes, yes.
Now, the house that was given to the parson, the house that was given to the parson, set aside for the apostle, is called the same thing today as it was called during slavery, especially if the church owns the property. It's called parsonage. And these pastors today that are called, they wear the better clothing, they have the better cars.
These
pastors got the jet planes, helicopters. They have, as Tony Maddox called them, they become ecclesiastical pimps. Their chore is to prepare black people for the final solution, which is to have us in the concentration camps, and eventually we are to be done the same thing they did to the enemies of
the
stamp right.
Yep.
Well, you see, the Jews would not have suffered long as much as they did had they not had collaborated by known as the Zionists. The Zionists collaborated both Mussolini and Hitler.
Yep.
And they had their eyes on a patch of land called Palestine, but Hitler couldn't deal with the Zionists. He wouldn't tell on them, and they wouldn't tell on Hitler, because Hitler was about to do his thing in the Warsaw ghetto. But it was clear that the Zionists collaborated with the Nazis, including Mussolini, to get their agenda across. And it's so clear that the Boulets, the secret orders today, their agenda is to go along to get along and not make any waves. But the masses of black people are caught up in a very diabolical situation that they will never be able to digest. What has been set up for them to deal with the question? They have the question resolved. It's the final solution.
Yes, you're totally right. You're on target, brother. And I always call that historical revisionism. They will use us in those stories. I do not believe the story of the Jews and the 6 million. I know better. And I also know what you just said, the Zionist Jews that was up in the Ashkenazi mountains that they brought out were sent into the Middle East to set up Israel so they could create Jesus and say he was walking with the white part of them rather than us coming out of Palestine and where he was from. Because everybody said, well, how can a white peckerwood come out of that heated area of the desert? And then they'll say, well, he was in Palestine, which is now Israel. So all of that's a story in all of the history. Ignorant, not knowing who we are, and not wanting to know if we're going to get ours in the by and by. So that Christianity bullshit, they can take it, and what is done to us is frozen. It has frozen our brain. And we don't know how to get out of it until we turn completely on it. And the preachers are not going to let you do it. So we got to go.
Those that come.
And those that don't, stay where you are. All right. I appreciate
that's
you calling.
You're right on the money.
Okay,
brother.
I appreciate you.
Thank you.
All right. You got anything else before we take a break?
Yeah, I just want to say, Well, we lost Dr. Ben, and he was one of my mentors, but we have not even digested the geniuses of this man. And we have to understand that the mainstream media didn't want us to know anything about his passing. The black media, we don't have any more responsible black media on the airwaves as far as on public broadcasting.
Cassie Hughes sold us out. Yes. All right, brother, we got to take a break. I hear the bump music in the back.
Yes.
So
okay,
appreciate your call.
Yep. Take care now.
All right.
Yes, sir.
All right. Are you there? Are you there, Sister Shira?
I am. You're going in and out on my end, though, but I am here.
Okay. Well, the brother came through clear, and he heard me clear. I don't know what you got.
Yeah.
You got one of them Kmart. You might have one of them Kmart telephones or something like that. You know what I mean?
I'll tell you, sure is acting up.
Yeah, but
I got this one from the 99-cent store, the way it's acting.
Yeah, 99. No, one of them dollar stores, yeah. All right, let's take a break. Let's take 10 minutes, and I'll be right back.
Okay, and we'll take another call when you come back.
You got a caller on there?
Right.
You
we do.
On there? Get him.
Yes,
get
we
it.
Do.
Let's get
okay.
it out of here.
Caller, we're coming to you, 281. This
yeah.
is... Zola. Okay. All right. Your mic is open.
Okay.
Yes, caller.
Uhuru, and I'm really receiving all of this information. I have two questions.
Yes.
One, and I'm sure you told us this, but give it to me again so that I can write it down. When? Can you hear me?
Okay.
Yes, I can. Yes. Go ahead.
Hello?
Yes, I can hear
oh,
you.
Okay. All right. All right. When, what year was Christianity developed?
Ooh.
When did it come into being, Christianity?
Well, that I cannot answer that unless we go with the Bible or we go with the Council of Nicene. Council of Nicene was in 325 A.D. after his death, and then King James did his malarkey in 1604 and completed it in 1611. So from that, I know the Council of Nicene, they created the Jesus, and they put the black priest out because he did not want to go along with the image of Michelangelo's sissy, faggot, brother-in-law who painted the picture of Jesus hanging on the cross. Now, that's the best I can tell you. That was in 325 A.D. It's called the Council of Nicene, N-I-C-E. Now, you can start there. Never heard
okay.
of Christianity
I want
before.
I want the truth. I don't want the malarkey. I know there's a lot of malarkey, but I want the truth. I want the facts.
What?
So I'll go with the 305.
Council of Nicene. Yes. 325
okay.
A.D., Council
All
of
right.
Nicene. And then you can search Constantine. He was the one that started the wars to spread that information from the Council of Nicene. His name was Constantine. He was a king, and he was over there in that, anyway, he was in the Middle East, not Far East. He was in, I can't call it, like Turkey. He was in that area of Turkey and Pakistan, stuff like that. All right? Now, you can do that research, and you'll find that information. And also, when the first Europeans were known as Christians, that was their nationality, Christians. When the Pope was feeding them to the lions, he called them Christians. Feed them to the lions. Are you there? Is anyone there? I guess not. All right, good people, I'm going to take a break and see what the problem is, and we'll be back in 10. Okay. Okay. The Act, ACT, of 1871. The Act of 1871. And I'm looking for a good sister to see if she's back in. We go down to the bottom. I don't see her down low. I'm going up. I don't see that she's back in yet. So I'm going to start reading this article. It's called, you can look it up. It's called the Act. ACT of 1871. The United States is a corporation. There are two constitutions. Now, the second Constitution, in part, is the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendment, plus the Library Code. The Library Code gives it the muscles that it needs to go to war against you. Okay? I'm still looking for did she tell me to call her? No. But I don't think she was on. So I there she is.
Okay. I think we're working right now.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
I was supposed to dial. Yeah, I got you. All right, here we go. We may want to stay over about 10 minutes or so, over 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, if you can. But I want to get this. I got an article called the Act of 1871, ACT, the Act of 1871. It's entitled, The United States is a Corporation. There are two constitutions. Since the Act of 1871, which established the District of Columbia, we have been living under the United States Corporation, which is owned by several international, or better yet, certain international banksters and aristocrats of Europe and Britain. Do y'all hear me? United States is a plantation. It's owned by certain international banksters and aristocrats of Europe and Britain. In 1871, the Congress changed the name of the original Constitution by changing one word. And that was very significant, as you will read. They changed one word.
Yes. Of.
Do you see? Did you pull it up? Are you looking at it, Ashura?
I'm getting ready to, right now.
All right. It's called the Act of 1871. The United States is a corporation. Yes. Now, it came off of the website of federaljack.com. I don't know if that's going to be significant. But I just went and put in United States of America, 1871, and I got it. It came up. Okay.
Yes, I see it. I have it.
All right. It said they changed one word. Some people do not understand that one word or two words difference in any legal document do make the critical difference, but Congress has known and does know. Congress has known and does know. This 1871, February 21, Congress passed an act to provide a government for the District of Columbia, also known as the Act of 1871. With no constitutional authority. Now understand, they didn't have any right to do it. With no constitutional authority to do so, Congress created a separate form of government for the District of Columbia, a 10 square miles parcel of land. See Acts of 41st Congress, Section 31, Section 3, Chapter 61, and 62. So I'm not lying to you. I'm giving it to you straight from the belly of the beast. This act, or the act, passed when the country was weakened and financially depleted in the aftermath of the Civil War, was a strategic move by foreign interests, international banksters, who were intent upon gaining a stranglehold on the coffers of the neck of America. Now, right there, you see they're talking about two different entities. The first part of this thing, they talked about United States set up a new corporation and a new constitution. And the last paragraph says it was set up upon gaining the stranglehold on the coffers, that's the money, and neck of America. Us, you people, us. We are American, not them. Okay? Man, this thing looks like it's mighty long. I'm not going as well. I know the two words that they changed was Constitution for America and Constitution of America. That one word, for, was changed to of. And that's what changed the whole significance of the first Constitution. They took for, F-O-R, out and put in of, which made it change altogether. Because now they're talking about of United States. The other one was for United States. We was in power in the first one. They stole power in the second one and by saying United States of America. Congress cut a deal with the international bankster, specifically Rothschilds of London, to incur a debt to said bankers because the banksters were not about to lend money to a fundling nation without serious stipulations. They devised a way to get their foot in the door of United States. Notice the language. The Act of 1871 formed a corporation called the United States, the corporation owned by foreign interests, moved in and shoved the original Constitution into a dustbin. With the Act of 1871, the original Constitution was defaced, in effect vandalized and sabotaged. When the title was capitalized and the word for, F-O-R, changed to of, O-F, in the title. The Constitution original said Constitution for United States of America. And this one said Constitution of United States of America. You get it? It sounds a little insignificant, but this is what gives the police departments. They belong to the corporations. Isn't it ironic that when you live in a city, municipal, village, township, you never have the authority to vote for your chief of police or any of those thugs known as policemen? Have you ever thought about that? The chief of police is appointed by the mayor. The mayor gets his instructions because the corporations funded his campaign. He knows that he's got to go with the corporation or they'll pull his money back or slander him so bad they'll do a recall and get rid of his butt. And out of all the positions that we need power in, it's got to be the police department. We have no control over them thugs. The chief of police or his band of crooks. No power. Now, the Constitution, the original, set up so that we would have control. They don't mention police departments, but they mention the sheriff. We control the sheriff department in your Wayne County because we vote for the sheriff. But they are all punks. Since you don't know the Constitution, they just play the role. Nobody challenging the sheriff to tell the police to get out of our community. They never do. They go along to get along. Since nobody knows to challenge them, the news media won't print it, the corporation won't say it, the politicians better not bring it up. You don't even know that you control the sheriff department. You can recall the sheriff.
Sure don't.
Y'all don't have no idea the power you have. They had back during the 208 and 210, when they was foreclosing, five sheriffs told the corporations to go to hell. We're not gonna go out there and take them houses from my people. And guess what they did? Since nobody knew what they were saying, they put the sheriff on the blacklist, and they sent the police, bailiffs, and assigned agents out and threw your ass out of the house. The law says the sheriff is supposed to do it. Since you don't read and you believe anything that you see on TV or from one of them jackleg-ass preachers or one of them boules, you just go along to get along. You should challenge everything you hear. You should challenge it. I don't care how it makes them feel uncomfortable. Because they ain't doing nothing but putting your ass to sleep.
Hmm.
Then you want to call
in
me to wake you up. I ain't going to wake your ass up. All right, let me get back. Oh, this is good tonight. All righty. Now, where am I at here? Yeah, there you go. The Constitution of the United States of America as the Constitution of the Corporate United States of America. It operates in an economic capacity and has been used to fool the people into thinking it governs the republic. It does not. Capitalization is not insignificant when one is referring to legal documents. This seemingly minor alteration has had a major impact on every subsequent generation of America. Why? Because everyone in America have now become, because of your birth certificate, which is a federal document, when it comes back, it's in all capital letters. So they create a false creature of law known as the straw man. You, not knowing what illegus means, I can spell it but have trouble pronouncing it, E-N-S, one word, L-E-G-I-S, illegus. You have trouble even pronouncing it as I do. You have no idea what the definition of illegus is.
Oh,
6415207. Yep. I don't know why they calling me. They know I'm on the air. All right.
Oh.
So you understand? You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
If you don't understand that all capital letters, like that gentleman we had on the show last week, old Sarge, he said it didn't make a difference. Well, I'm sorry to say, Sarge, it creates a creature that resembles, or how do they use that word? That's a contrast. They create a creature like Casper that's a contrast to your name. So if your name is Sarge, the creature's name is Sarge, but Sarge with the creature is in all capital letters, and Sarge with the real Sarge is upper and lower caps. And he said that didn't make a difference. I knew I was talking to an idiot when he said that, so I let it alone. But a lot of people don't realize it. And for anybody listening that doubt me, just take your wallet or purse out, pull out your driver's license, credit card, or anything with your name on it that came from the corporation, and I'm telling you now, it's in all capital letters. One person told me one time, well,
yeah, driver's license.
Yes, driver's
you're
license.
You're going in and
all caps.
Oh, yes, all caps.
All caps. Credit card.
And your bills.
Your
statements.
All caps.
Mm-hmm.
It's not you. It's the creature that they created coming out of this 1871 malarkey. It's all a fiction of your imagination. And since it sounds like you, you think it is you. Jonah was saying the other week, he knew some guys that went to jail on some crimes. I have no idea what it was. And once they separated themselves from the corporation, They had to let him out of jail. They had the wrong person in jail. They should have put the birth certificate in jail, not the individual. That's how critical this is. It sounds crazy. It sounds stupid. It sounds unbelievable. But when they say Ron March, I hesitate. What the hell was that? I have no idea who you're talking about. Okay? Now, let's get back for a minute.
Okay.
What Congress did by passing the Act of 1871 was create an entity, new document of the Constitution for the government of the District of Columbia, an incorporated government. This newly altered Constitution was not intended to benefit the Republic. It benefits only corporations of the United States of America and operates entirely outside the original organic Constitution. So your police departments, I just told you, the police departments, the policemen come from the chief. The chief comes from the mayor, and the mayor is put in office by the corporations. So why would they want to help you when they have to swear to uphold and protect the corporations? And that's why these cops is killing these black boys. They got they got something already set up. So when they put the cameras on every cop, it's not going to stop them. All they have to do is grab that person, yank him toward him, hit him in the head with a blackjack, and keep screaming into the microphone, "Stop resisting, stop resisting." And every time he tries to say, "I ain't resisting," hit him in the head. Bam, boom, stop resisting, boom, stop resisting. Now, when the tape comes out, the police and them will say, since it's an in-house investigation, they're going to say, well, the man was trying to get away, and the cop, it was a good arrest, because the cop followed the book to the T. And everybody going to say, yeah, because the guy had a prison record. He stole some apples when he was 2 years old, or he stole a bicycle, or he beat up somebody and had police come in, all of that kind of crap. You see what I'm saying? This is madness, what they're doing. It's madness.
Yes,
now,
it is.
Everybody out there, I bet you haven't heard of the worst killing this year of the police department. The worst on record. The worst killing of a black male. He was 31 years old. A black male in New Jersey. Y'all look this up, because I know you're going to call me a liar. These cops arrested this guy, handcuffed him from behind, threw him on the ground and beat him, stood over in the corner and smoked cigarettes and talked out of sight and neck, and let the dogs loose. The dogs ate the man to death.
Mm-hmm. Sure did.
Within three months ago. They won't even put that on TV. I've been waiting on it to come on TV. It was out of New Jersey, so all of y'all out there, put in there, New Jersey dogs maul an arrested person. Put that in there and see if it don't come up. They even got a tape of it. And
yep,
they went
I saw
and,
it.
Yes. So you know I ain't lying. And they went They went to the guy that took the tape and took his camera away from him. Give me that damn telephone and get on out of here. There ain't none of your business. And the dogs was eating the man while he was handcuffed on the ground, laying on his stomach. Ate his face, y'all. Ate his face.
Yeah. Yeah, he did. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, that's just like when this other slagger guy over in North Charleston, South Carolina, after he shot the man, Scott, when he picked him up and handcuffed him, he just threw his face right back down in the mud like he was just throwing the dead animal down in the ground. He don't know if the man needed CPR. Essentially, he just let him smother to death and drown in his own blood or fluids or whatever.
Yes.
So,
yes.
I mean, and also the cops in Baltimore that broke that man's legs, spinal cord, and his voice box. And still drag them in the truck. And you mean to tell me you got to think about, you got to figure out if some charges should be brought? They need to turn Baltimore inside out.
And he died on the way to the hospital. So they said. The one in
poor Tulsa. Poor was just hanging on.
The one in Tulsa with the 73-year-old millionaire.
Yes.
When he shot him, he was handcuffed on the ground. He was trying to shoot him with a taser. Everybody said, well, why would you shoot him at all? He's already handcuffed. Do you know he died on the way to the hospital?
Mm-hmm.
I think that was the one. I might have it mixed up. There's been so many. Where are them
Jacqueline? Yeah, yeah, he does.
Yeah. Where are them preachers?
Where's T.D. Jakes? Where's T.D. Jakes?
Yes. Yes. And that other sister.
Where's T.D. Snakes?
What's that one down in Atlanta, Georgia?
Okay. You're talking about either Creflo Dollar or either Bishop Eddie Long. Where are they? Uh-huh.
And them bougie niggas are still tearing the door down on Sunday to get in there to get blessed so they can go to heaven.
Yeah. Right, and I was just about to say, and where are the members? Where are they? And this pastor here that wanted people to help him get his helicopter fixed. I think it was, I don't want to call his name, the name wrong.
Call him anything.
Yes.
Who cares? Call him anything.
Nigga preacher. That's what I call him.
Yeah,
nigga preacher.
That's a good one. That's a good one. They know who you're talking about.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable.
Oh, yeah, they know.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, so my point is, in this article, it gives you all the information. It tells you where to go to look at all. This is good. I thought it was longer, but it's not. It gives you the information. It tells you where to go to look it up. It says that, let me see. By passing the act, Congress committed treason, listen to me, against the people who were sovereign under the grants and decrees of the Declaration of Independence. I read that for you. And the organic constitution. You were under a republic. But when they changed it in 1871, you became a slave. And the United States of America became the plantation. We all are in debt. Everyone in America is in debt. Now, how is that? And you won't get out of debt. And yet you pay for everything you have, you've already paid for. This is madness. The Act of 1871 became the foundation. All the treason since, let me read it a bit again. The Act of 1871 became the foundation of all the treason since committed by the government officials. They all agreed to this in 1871. And these punks over there now try to act like it didn't happen or they didn't have anything to do with it, but they're all living off of a false government. Ever since Sinaidae, S-I-N-E-D-I-E, Sinaidae, in 1861, claimed that Congress walked out. That's what the lie they put out. But that was the date that they changed from America, of America, to for America. The of and the for came into play. And your 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments were set up to create the Constitution that they used. Because when you read the 14th Amendment, it talks about all of the good stuff that was in the original Constitution, such as we got to pay the debt of all of Congress that we had nothing to do with creating. And we are saying nothing and keep sending these bums to represent us. That's the part that hurts.
Every one of them that gets elected
tells the same lie, I'm going to go in and represent the people. And as soon as the election's over, you can't find them sissies nowhere.
Can't find them. If you come to their office, they're not there. They give you the run around.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Give you that double talk. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, what I'm saying to you is the 14th Amendment and the 14th Amendment citizen is the worst piece of crap that ever came on earth. Now, let me say this real quick. The Sesecu Trust, I know everybody's kind of heard of that. You may if you're on the phone, I guess you'll stay on the line. So you'll let me know that you're on the line, Ashir, when they shut it down. Listen to this. The only trust that don't have three parts to it that I know of is only one. It's called the Siskiyou Trust. It does not have a donor. You tell me, you're a female. You tell me why it doesn't have a donor when it was founded by the mother. When the mother filled out the live birth record application, she created the Siskiyou account. When I come to Mississippi, I'm going to bring that information to show you.
Oh, yes, please.
Signed a document that she had kidnapped that baby, and she
what?
Put it into the vital statistics. Y'all sign it and don't even know you signed it.
So that's what that birth certificate is when we're signing it?
Yes. But see, you don't sign.
Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio. Goodbye.
And in that application, I got a copy of it. It's in every state. It's in every state. And if y'all listening tomorrow, I'll be on at 6 o'clock. I'm going to bring those documents. I got the information from Michigan, and I got it from Ohio. You need to look in your constitution and compile laws and find it wherever you live. But it all says the same thing. They call it fondling kidnap. No, fondling unparentage. I ain't never heard that word, unparentage.
Say it again.
FOUNDLING. Foundling.
Okay.
Unparentage.
Wow. Okay.
You look that up, it'll tell you exactly what that mama had to sign before she could get out of the hospital. That's why they make her a infant when the paperwork comes back, because she takes herself off of the birth of the child, because she is a snitch that turned the child in to vital statistics.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's madness. And
it
mothers
is.
Sign it because the nurses tell you that you're signing a paper to pay the doctors, to pay the insurance, and you want to be.
Okay.
Uh-huh. They give you all of
uh-huh.
that song and dance.
Et cetera.
They smile at you,
mm-hmm.
give you some flowers. All that baby so cute, a little buzzard head rising uh-huh. man up there. Oh, he's so cute. Here, my yes.
Yeah. Look, Brother Ron, and then they have y'all yeah. morphined up, y'all drugged out and everything. You know, they have a good little game going on.
Yeah, big game. And they win every time.
A big game. Win every time.
It's a mirage. You think you're doing the right thing, and you giving a baby up and tell them don't put you in jail because you just kidnapped it and you gave it back to the pack of wood.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Now,
so let me ask you this.
Yes.
So even if you were to have a midwife to come to the home to deliver
yes.
the baby, do you still have to go to the hospital and sign those documents?
No. That's why it's illegal to have a midwife.
Say what?
It's illegal to have a midwife. I don't know.
It's illegal?
It's illegal. Do you know a minute?
I've heard about mm-hmm. some still practicing. Let me not call their names out, though, because if it's illegal,
all
I
right.
don't
want
to call anybody
me.
Out, and I don't want the police coming to them because they're going to try to kill them.
Listen uh-huh. to me. They passed a law that was, I had a lady back in the 80s that lived four doors from me, and that's what she did. And there was a nun from the Catholic Church. That's all she did. They passed a law that they couldn't do it anymore. I didn't look into it because I wasn't interested at the time. But they couldn't do it. One lady went back to the church. She was already in the Catholic stuff. The other lady went to St. Thomas. She moved to St. Thomas.
Brother Ron, you're breaking up so badly. I can't even hear anything. Well, I know that on my end... I've been cut off, So I can't take any more calls in.
All right.
It just cut off like about 3 minutes ago.
Yes. Mine is also off. But if they're on the line, they can hear you.
Mm-hmm.
At least
yes. You were about to say about tomorrow. So what time will you be on tomorrow?
Tomorrow
and how can we tune in?
At 6 o'clock Detroit time, I'll be on, and we're going to explore that 14th Amendment again. Because everybody needs to know that there are two citizens. The 14th Amendment, there's a public and a private. And if you can't get that in your head, you might as well stay a slave. Because if you can't understand that, you need to call in and ask questions. And if you can't understand it, you might as well forget it. So we're going to go into that. And I'm going to bring those laws that I just told you about that I have of Michigan and Ohio, and I'll read them to you.
Okay.
And that is
So you'll be on tomorrow at 6 p.m. Central
Eastern
Time.
Eastern Standard Time.
Eastern, yes, that's right.
Yes, 5 o'clock your time.
No. Yeah. Right. Okay. So, and what's the number? What's the number for people to call in?
You can call this same number, 718-506-1864.
Okay.
And her number, I don't have it in front of me, but give me 1 second. I might be able to pull it up if I do it fast. Hold on.
Okay.
Who?
It's Beverly. Beverly D. Show on
Beverly
Blog Talk.
D. Yes.
Mhm. So if people type in Beverly D. or either type in Ron March Show.
Yep.
We'll be able to
you
catch
it
tomorrow evening. Mhm.
Yes. And I'll email you her blog number, and then you can give it to your people. You can blog it tomorrow. Okay.
Yes. Okay.
All right, good sister, I appreciate you. I hope your guests and my guests got something out of this. We all was on target. I was just trying to lay
yes,
it out.
Oh, yes. And you did. We lost a few people, though, with the technical difficulties in the beginning, but that's okay because we'll pick back up.
Yes. They got to understand that we're fighting not only our equipment, we're fighting the feds, too.
Yes, indeed.
You know what I mean? He did not want this information to come out. So until we meet again, I'll say I'm out of here. And peace.
Okay. All right.
You.
Peace.